Hi, this is Elliot Eisenberg of Graphs and Laughs, here to catch you up to date on the latest in residential sales data. In Hillsborough County, single-family and multifamily home prices both rose by about 3%. If you look at sales activity, it's down almost 19% on the single-fam side and about 12% on the multifam side. If we look at sales price to original listing price, in both for both single and multi, it's at 96.3, well down from what it was last year at 100% for single-fam and almost 102 for multifam. Pending sales continue to weaken. They're down almost 12% on the single fam side and almost 3% on the multifam side. Lastly, inventory's up a lot, at least in percentage terms, 130% on the single fam side and 175% on the multifam side, but we still are inventory starved. We've got just 1.9 months of inventory on both the single and multifamily sides. In Pasco County, single-fam home prices were utterly flat compared to a year ago, whereas in the multifam case, they were up 7.6. The single-fam number was the worst of all three counties and all both types of properties, whereas the multifam was the best of all three counties and both types of properties. So it's very interesting, the extremes in Pasco County. Sales activity is down here. It's down 12% for single-fam and 6% for multifam. As a sales price, as a functional list price, like everywhere else, is about 96, well down from about 100% last year for both single and multifamily. Pending sales did very, very well in Pasco County, up 1.6 on the single fam side and 18.3 on the multifam, again, by far the best. Inventory's up 130% on single and about 300% on multi. And while that sounds like a lot in terms of percentage points, there's not a lot of inventory, just 1.7 months on the single fam side and 2.2 on the multi. We remain inventory starved. In Pinellas County, single fam home prices went up a smidge, almost 2.5%, and on the multifam side, a little better at 5.5%. Sales activity declined for both types of properties, down about 10% for single and down 16% for multifamily. In terms of sales price as a function of list price, in both counties, it was right around 96%, well down from last year's almost 102 for single and 100% for multifamily. This market, like every other market in the Tampa area, is weakening. Pending sales down 14% for single fam and 12% for multi. Lastly, inventories up 90% for single family and comically 200% for multi. And while that sounds like a large increase, there's still not much inventory out there. On the single fam side, just 1.7, and on the multifam, 2.9. We're also inventory starved, even with the large percentage increases. Turning our attention to the national scene, GDP in 22 Q3 and Q4 was really strong at 2.6% annualized and 2% annualized. Unfortunately, in 23 Q1, GDP came in at an anemic 1.1%. Unfortunate. That said, inflation remained very strong and wage growth also remained strong. This combination of strong inflation and strong wage growth has made the Fed very nervous. The Fed's fearful that if wage growth stays strong, that will keep inflation strong because much of the cost of producing a service or good are wages, the people that do the stuff. So as a result, it was no surprise at all that the Fed raised rates by a quarter point early this month. And it's also interesting that I think the Fed is now opening the door to the possibility of raising rates again, if necessary, if inflation and wage growth remain strong. These are big concerns for the Fed. As far as we're concerned, interest rates in April didn't do much of anything, and I strongly suspect that by the end of this year, interest rates will be in the fives. Economic growth will slow, long-term interest rates will decline, and along with them, the 30-year rate. My concern going forward remains the possibility or the likelihood of a recession in the second half of this year, late Q3 or Q4. That said, I'm not sure it will have much of an impact on housing because housing has already experienced quite a decline in sales activity from late 21, early 2022. That's it for now. I look forward to seeing you next month.